I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
I see you're getting in shape. You're losing weight, huh? You're getting ripped. He's getting ready for Mayweather McGregor.
What's up,
Ellie? Dana White watches our videos.
You still have a lot of weight to do.
Everyone watches your videos. Wow. Wow.
McGregor watches the videos.
I know he doesn't.
So let me ask you this. We're a week away. What's your prediction?
McGregor in five.
What do you say? McGregor in five? McGregor in five?
She doesn't watch fighting. She doesn't watch fighting the way that you don't watch MMA.
Why do you say Conor in five?
Because I just like to say it.
What do people say? You're in a boxing gym, and you're probably the only person in this gym that has that prediction.
Probably.
Did they agree or did I argue with you?
I mean, there's no argument. Everyone has a difference of opinion. I'm not going to argue about it. I would prefer to see McGregor in them over Mayweather.
You're both in the boxing world and in the MMA world. We all watch Conor train, but a lot of people didn't understand what they were watching. Can you explain to people what they were watching when he was training?
Which part? The McGregor challenge?
Yes.
See, well, here's the thing, is people should do their research. So here's what I think is funny, is people are not open-minded to stuff, right? So maybe 5-6 years ago, you'd see people hit mitts. People would hit mitts, and they hit mitts like whatever their famous boxer was at the time. Right? And then Mayweather gets popular, right? Where he is now. And this whole pity pat style Roger Mayweather shit that he does, this orchestrated mitt thing that he does, that people actually start advertising. Well, I teach the Floyd Mayweather mitt stuff. And now that's the popular thing, right? So basically what you have is a bunch of followers running around. Okay? So if you do your research, there's a guy named Ido Portell who practices movement. And I'm not going to get into all of it because you can just...
I met him last week.
Portell. Yeah.
But how does that help you as a fighter doing movement?
Movement helps you a lot. It helps you with balance. It helps you with control. It helps you with manipulation of situations. It helps you with understanding range and distance. I mean, that's the whole purpose of movement is to be in better control of your body, to understand what positions are advantageous or what positions are disadvantaged. So part of what he was doing was an exercise to engage and re-engage the shoulders, to loosen up, to be a little bit more fluid in his movement. So here's what happens. Here's the funny thing. So let's go to an alternate dimension where McGregor sparks Mayweather, right? And all these guys like Terrence Crawford, all these other
David Haye,
all these other boxers, right? All these guys decide that, oh my God, what is it that he did? What did he spark? What did he do? And now what you're going to see is all these guys looking up and getting in the movement because what did Conor do? He sparked Mayweather. He knocked Mayweather out. And then they're going to look at what he did and go, well, maybe that shit works. Well, the problem is that's the difference between having an open mind and understanding. There have been guys who've been MMA for years, who've been on movement for years, and they've been very successful at it. It's a very effective way to train if you're trying to be limber, if you're trying to be flexible, and especially if you want fluidity. But, you know, everybody wants to make fun of it because
you're not familiar with it, because it's different. It's new.
But the mitt work shit, that totally works, right? It's totally,
it's
totally applicable for a fight.
It works for whoever does it.
It works for muscle memory and maybe for a warm-up or a cool-down or to look good in the cameras if you can't really throw a lot of hard punches because you got brittle hands. Yeah, it works really well. But as far as being applicable and having any kind of functionality in a fight, it does not. You don't extend your arms. You don't throw any power. You don't effectively deflect or defend punches. It just looks good. Okay? It just looks good.
They're fighting in 8 ounces. What's the difference? Who is it, an advantage for Floyd? Like a lot of people are telling me, because he fought his entire career for 46 out of 49 fights he fought in 8 ounces. Or is it McGregor who usually fights in 4 to move up to 8?
I don't think that makes a difference.
No, it doesn't make a difference. What about the referee, Robert Byrd? Advantage for Floyd, advantage for Conor, or neither?
I don't know shit about referees.
Well, he did the fight of...
I know Joe Cortez is, and I remember, who was that, Mills Lane? That's the last time I paid attention to a referee.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Setback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Setback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSetback. Take a step back. Who is Ellie Setback?